Hi, Cornerstone Kids. It's Mrs. Fairbanks. I hope your first week of remote learning went well. For the next week in food school, what I want you to do, I know that you love peanut butter. You love peanut butter sandwiches anyway. So I would like to continue what we were doing at when you were at Cornerstone and actually have you pick out five foods that you think you might be able to tolerate exploring in some peanut butter, so dipped in some peanut butter. And then I want you to go through our steps. So what does it look like? Okay, once you dip that food into the peanut butter, now it's going to change. So what does it look like now that it's dipped in the peanut butter? Does it have spots on it? Does it have a darker brown spot now on it because it has the peanut butter, right? Does it look shiny to you? What does it look like, right? Okay, and then our next one was smell. So now that we added the peanut butter, did that change the smell? Does it have a smaller smell? Does it have a bigger smell? How did it change when we added the peanut butter? Okay. The third one is going to be touch. So now when you touch it's probably going to change now that it's dipped in the peanut butter. Most likely all of them are going to be stickier. But how did that particular food change now when you touched it? Okay, what changed about how it feels to you? Does it feel cold now when it didn't? Does it feel gritty now to you? How did it change now when you touch it? Okay, the next one is what does it taste like? So is it sweet, salty, or bitter? Okay, probably. I mean, I'm sure you have a guess as to what peanut butter tastes like. So now that we added that might make all the foods taste like peanut butter, or maybe some of them will maintain what they tasted like before they had the peanut butter on them. You'll have to let me know. You'll have to be the scientist, okay? The next one is going to be sounds in your mouth. So remember when you're in food school, you can bite down on it and we can hear what it sounds like in your mouth. And then if you don't feel comfortable chewing and swallowing it, feel free to spit it into like a Kleenex or a napkin too, and we can throw that away. But I think if you're picking out all five of the foods that you should be able to dip them in the peanut butter and then at least have them in your mouth to listen to hear, did it change the sound when the peanut butter is on it? I know that sometimes when we dip crunchy things in peanut butter, it now changes it to maybe more of it's an initial crunch and loud, and then all of a sudden it becomes quieter, right? Because the peanut butter causes it to be mushier, okay? So go ahead and make a list of those five foods, and then across the top, list those different senses that we're exploring, okay? And then you can kind of go down through the page and write down scientifically what you're exploring with the foods that you've chosen, okay? So that's it for your assignment for this next week for food school. Please know that speech and feeding are an extra, so it is not mandatory that you complete any of these. It's completely up to you and your family dynamics. If you guys have time, great. If not, I completely understand. No pressure. Okay. I'm praying for each one of you guys at 7:30 in the morning. If you have specific prayer requests, go ahead and send them to me through email, and I will make sure to pray over them. I miss you guys very much. Just know that God is good, and He is big, and He is in control of everything. So, bye, guys. I'll see you next week.